Hello, my name is Donna Clement Petrushka, and I'm the daughter of Kim Clement. And this is Codebreakers Prophetic Alert. We just did a Codebreakers less than 2 weeks ago on Iran, Russia, and Syria. And I'd like to give you a quick update on what has occurred between Israel, Iran, and Syria this past week. If you haven't seen our last Codebreakers, you can watch it on our broadcast from February 3rd of 2018, or on our new House of Destiny app, which you can download now on all platforms. Just go to Media in the app and click on Codebreakers to watch our most recent Codebreakers segment. Now, I want you to see what's transpired since last Friday between Israel, Iran, and Syria, and then hear what my dad, Kim Clement, prophesied about this back in 2014 and 2012, where he was actually in Jerusalem. And pay attention to what he said to Prime Minister Netanyahu.
New information from the Middle East now. Israel sends a stark warning to Iran after conducting airstrikes over the weekend against Iranian and Syrian forces in Syria.
I've been warning for some time about the dangers of Iran's military entrenchment in Syria. Iran seeks to use Syrian territory to attack Israel for its professed goal of destroying Israel. Israel holds Iran and its Syrian host responsible for today's aggression. We will continue to do whatever is necessary to protect our sovereignty and our security.
Joining us now, Lieutenant Colonel Daniel Davis, senior fellow and military expert at Defense Priorities. The Israelis have been trying to stay out of this Syrian war as much as possible. They went after what they say are Iranian targets. The Iranians denied that they had any personnel there. Where is the truth, Colonel?
Well, I think when you look at what actually happened, it's Iran can deny it all day long, but I think in the end, it's pretty clear that they did lose some troops. Independent reporting from the region confirms this. And, you know, Israel has the right to defend themselves. And when you have, whether it was Syrian or an Israeli drone entering their airspace, they absolutely have the right to shoot that down and then to retaliate as they did. And, you know, you'd think at some point that Syria and Iran realized that Israel's serious about their security, and then you can't just play around with them.
Yeah, well, and they had an Israeli F-16 that was shot down a couple of days back. The pilots ejected and escaped, but that's the first time Israel has lost a warplane since, what, 1982?
Right. Yeah, 1982. And what apparently happened was that they were swamped with a number of, I think, more than a dozen different anti-aircraft missiles, one of which finally got close enough to disable the aircraft. But that didn't work out very well for Syria or Iran either, because in retaliation, Israel went back and completely wiped out a number of different batteries. So the net for Israel and Syria was a definite win for Israel. And I think Syria is going to really consider again before they allow their airspace and their personnel to be used as a surrogate by Iran to do anything to Israel.
But that is the question. I mean, could this thing continue to escalate upwards from here?
No, I don't think so, because certainly Syria definitely cannot afford to have yet another military enemy, you know, because they're still fighting for their lives in there. And Iran is struggling as they are. They're actually still struggling internally. So the last thing they need is to actually add to their difficulties. And they also don't want to spawn the military from the Israeli Defense Force, which is clearly the most powerful one in the region, against their assets there. So they want to try to be under the radar, but this time that they went too far.
But the Russians are propping up the Syrian government. And what are the dangers of Russian involvement, maybe against Israel here?
Right, and that is one of the definite the problems that afflicts the whole area. And this whole Syria thing really exposes just how fragile and chaotic the whole Middle East is, but especially in Syria. Russia definitely does not have any interest in engaging military operations against Israel, so they're raising their concerns about that, but apparently the high-level delegations between the two nations are trying to deconflict. But Russia's on a very delicate timeline because they want to defend their own interests in the Middle East, but they don't want to expand it into something that they don't even want to get into. So it's a danger, but I think that we're going to be able to navigate this.
There is anger. There is discord. But there will come an act of rage, and they shall focus on Israel. That they will do it sly and subtle, via Iran. I am watching, and my servants are praying. For the more they curse, the more cursed they shall become. But in this nation, there will be a rage that will come from the White House. But it will bring so much exposure that it shall once again be an act of my protection over my people. Am Yisrael Chai! Am Yisrael Chai!
No stone can take down the fruitless, perverted mind of your enemies. But the words that came from David's mouth, speaking without fear, today I will take you down. No matter what the words were of Goliath, no matter what the words are from Syria, Iran, Afghanistan, China, Russia, North Korea, and two other little places that will join to rise up. Watch how I stand like I did with David, who said, today, this month, I will arise and lead your prime minister, your king, Netanyahu. You are chosen to speak before you cast the rock. You are chosen to speak before you cast the weapon. For their weapons are at a certain point and they are trigger happy. For they are enticing you to come to them. But stand still and see the salvation of the Lord, Netanyahu. Netanyahu, God is with you, O Israel.
Thank you for joining me for this Codebreakers prophetic alert. Keep praying and keep your eyes on this because there's more to come. You can email us at codebreakers@houseofdestiny.org because we love to hear from you and what you think. Before I leave you, I want to read you what my father said on December 1st of 2011. And this is what he said. Therefore, this is what God says. My people who live in Israel, who live in Zion, do not be afraid of Iran. Do not be afraid of Syria. Do not be afraid of Russia. Do not be afraid of these nations who try and beat you with a rod and lift up their hands against you. But God says, my anger against them will end this destruction. I will lash them with a whip like I did before. This is the word of the Lord. Thank you for watching Codebreakers. If you'd like to see more, subscribe to our YouTube channel or download our app. Search House of Destiny in any app store. For links, please look in the description section of this video. We'll see you next time.